The first dish I'm going to cook for you today is a dish that's been on our menu since we opened. It's a dish of raw scallops that have been slightly pickled in elderflower vinegar. Served with cucumber rolled in ash made from its own skin. It's finished with a sauce made from horseradish and dill. We thinly slice the scallops around the thickness of a pound coin, and we lay them onto a tray. We slightly dress them in elderflower vinegar that we made last year. So we pickle all the elderflower down and hold it for the year. A little bit of modern sea salt. Then that gets laid on the plate. Alongside that, we have Parisienne of cucumber, so small balls of cucumber. Some that have also been dressed in rapeseed oil and elderflower vinegar. And then others that have been rolled in an ash made from burnt cucumber skins and mixed with dill oil to make almost a black paste. We roll the balls in that. They sit alongside each other. And then it's finished with nasturtium leaves, a cucumber flower, and then a sauce that's made from cream infused with horseradish. And then we split that out with an oil made from dill. So next dish I'm going to cook for you is our dish of raw beef. So it's inspired by beef tartare. The way we do it here is we don't chop the beef, we slightly scrape it to give it that nice texture. What we do with that is we dress that with diced compressed apple, rapeseed oil, molten sea salt, and toasted rye bread. Once we take that mix, what we do is we hollow out an apple that's served over a bed of ice, and then we build that up inside the apple. So we start at the bottom with a little bit of truffle mayonnaise, some apple jelly, and then we take our beef mix of beef, toasted rye bread, compressed apple, and pile that up on top. And then we finish on top with some more truffle mayonnaise, a layer of apple jelly, like a disc of jelly that sits on top, and then shaved fresh black truffle on the top of that. And then we put that apple back together so it just looks like a whole apple served over the ice. And then that goes out into the room with a little bit of liquid nitrogen and water to create a cloud effect, and that gets served to the guests at the table. The dessert I'm going to cook for you today is on the menu is simply known as flour custard. So it's a homemade custard, and then on top of that we take a selection of grown and wild flowers that we dress on top of the custard, and then we create a rose out of a compressed pear that's been compressed in a rose vinegar. So we have wild pickled and candied Alexander stems that come from Kent that are foraged for us, pickled nasturtium flowers, pickled viola flowers. And then we simply lay them all over the top of the custard, and that's it, finished.